I'm here with many, many great people from the home tonight and from the community, as you can see. And I'm not here to do a lot of talking, so I'm going to be the introducing person. So we're going to get started. And the program is basically very simple. We're going to have four speakers who I will introduce one at a time. We'll have, following our final speaker, we'll have a 77-second moment of silence, after which our fabulous musicians will bring us
Thank you all for coming. Hello, my name is Joseph Ramirez. I am a CNA at the Holyoke Soldiers Home and a CIU local EAA chapter vice president. I speak today on behalf of my fellow staff members, represented by EAA, the Massachusetts Nurses Association, and SEIU NAGE. The end of March marks 1 year since the COVID-19 pandemic struck our home, taking from our community at least 76 of our veterans, causing devastation, illness among our staff, and leaving scars that will forever be embedded in our souls. We are here today to remember the amazing veterans we knew so well, who we cared for and supported, admired, and treated like family. Their loss aches in our hearts. We also want to express love and support for our veterans' families and our community. The hurt we all felt is intertwined and inseparable, but so too is our strength. In countless ways, we have carried each other through this devastation. Sharing this loss also means we have the opportunity to heal together. We gather here today especially in support of our colleagues. To you we say, you are resilient. You are not alone. You are loved. We have always cared for our veterans with honor and dignity. Together we witness horror and we felt anger, confusion, sadness, and grief. The trauma remains inside of us today. It impacts our work, our relationships, our lives, and our sense of home. Trauma can wreak havoc on our ability to understand and process our emotions. It can make us feel unmoored and disconnected. The sudden loss of people we care for, repeated again and again, was a horrible shock to our system that would not simply go away. All departments up to and including leadership, we were all damaged by this trauma. Yet we never strayed from our mission to care for our veterans with honor and dignity. We come back to work, we care for the survivors, and we work out ways to care for each other. The more we have leaned on each other, the more we have been able to find ways to heal. We persevere. As we move past the 1 year anniversary of the tragedy, we look to the future. We hope. Many of our staff are being connected with the resources they need to solve their problems. The legislature is planning a major investment to modernize the home. Our staff and the unions representing us have shared our recommendations with elected officials and trustees. Our voices are being heard and we will make positive change together. This vigil is an important moment for us all. It is a real, tangible action we are taking to remember the past and to look forward to the future. I hope this vigil will lead to more reflection and more healing beyond today. Every day we should be compassionate with each other like we are today. When we are kind and supportive, when we truly listen and try to meet the needs of those in our workplace and our community, we can overcome anything. Thank you for your love and support. Thank you for being here. Together, we are so strong.
welcome. Tonight, we, the employees of the Soldiers' Home, gather together to support one another in strength and solidarity, and to reflect, honor, and remember our veterans. Regardless of one's title, position, department, or union affiliation, we as a collective staff have experienced tremendous loss and unimaginable grief, second only to that of our veterans' family members themselves. Over this past year, many of us have shared in each other's pain and sorrow, while others have mourned alone. Tonight, we join together as co-workers, family members, friends, and the community to acknowledge the heartache and devastation, validate the significance of the loss of our veterans, and mourn together. Our veterans were and are the heart of the Soldiers' Home, the very foundation of our work, and we are entrusted to care for them with honor and dignity. After an invisible enemy entered our home last March, despite our own fears, fatigue, illness, and unknowns, the staff continued to dutifully, lovingly, and unconditionally provide care to the men and women we respect and love with unwavering strength, compassion, and dedication. We cared for them as if they were our own and attempted to fill all voids of not having their own loved ones by their sides. Faithfully, we have remained here through loss, heartache, and grief to continue providing our best care to those who survived, as well as to their families. Not a day has gone by since COVID first struck that we have forgotten our veterans and their families, as they are and will forever be embedded in our minds and our hearts. To the nation, they may have been seen as numbers, statistics, and headlines, but to us, they were and are our heroes. They were artists, musicians, salesmen, masons, nurses, machinists, police officers, teachers, firemen, postal workers, career military, farmers, activists, and so much more. They were spouses, parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, aunts, uncles, friends, and most importantly, heroes. We have been blessed and privileged to have known them, cared for them, and to have loved them all. We will forever be indebted to them for their bravery, dedication, and service to our country. To the families of our veterans, please know we sincerely grieve with you each and every day. You and your loved ones will forever be in our hearts. To our veteran survivors and their families, your ongoing strength, patience, support, and advocacy are not only admirable, but are inspirational and so greatly appreciated. We thank you. To our friends and family, thank you for your love and unending support over this past year. To the community, thank you for your support, advocacy, and commitment to all of our veterans, the staff, and to the future of a new and amazing Soldiers' Home. And finally, to the Soldiers' Home staff, your strength, perseverance, and dedication are true testaments to your character and steadfast commitment to our veterans. You are a beacon of hope and resiliency for the Soldiers' Home. In unity, we will continue to reflect, heal, and rise. We will remain Soldiers' Home strong.
I know that this is an emotional moment for many of us. And even though we are wearing masks, I can see it in the eyes, I can see it in our hearts, that this has been a difficult time and how important it is for us to be together this evening. I'm reading a book just published last year by someone named Jonathan Sacks called Morality, Restoring the common good in divided time. He asks us to imagine, I quote, that you have a certain measure of influence or friendship or knowledge or love, and you decide to share it with 9 others. You do not end up having less. You may have more. That is because these are social goods, goods that exist by sharing. These are goods that have a moral or spiritual dimension, and they have this rare quality that the more we share, the more we have. A society with a strong shared moral code is a high-trust place where the winners set an example of caring for the losers, indeed where they do not speak of them as losers at all, but as fellow citizens. High-trust societies are those in which the we resonates louder than the I, where people in distress find comfort in community rather than in being left to suffer on their own. We need to recover this sense of all of us together. That's the end of his words. And I want to say that you, the members of this Soldiers Home community, who are here tonight, embody this crucially important sense of all of us together. You, the devoted staff of this Soldiers Home, have all the qualities that Sachs has mentioned. A certain measure of influence, friendship, knowledge, and love. And throughout this most difficult and challenging year, you have opened your hearts and given of yourselves, sharing those qualities with the veterans at this home, so that they could, again, in Sachs's words, find comfort in community rather than being left to suffer on their own. Your commitment, your selflessness, your courage and devotion to the veterans is exemplary and deeply appreciated. Just as the veterans have exhibited these qualities in their service to our country, you have demonstrated those same qualities in service to our veterans. To the families of the veterans who have fought sickness this year, you have held and supported your loved ones throughout this ordeal, providing love and hope. And to those here this evening who have lost family members, our hearts and our prayers go out to you and to your departed. This community of all of us together acknowledge and share the pain of your loss. You are not alone. Thank you all for being here for one another. Thank you for standing up for the greater good, for giving of yourselves for the well-being of others. And so I end with this prayer. May the love and devotion that is shared with one another bring you healing, bring you hope, and bring you renewal.
When I was asked to come here to talk to you, part of a healing service, I couldn't help but want to come. I've been coming to this institution for the last 14 years serving these men, and I've witnessed the dedication of the staff that works here, that truly cared for these men, who loved these men. And when I think of how can you heal, the first thing that comes to my mind may sound odd to you, but it's forgiveness. To forgive, not always easy, sometimes seemingly impossible. There's no coincidence that there's a phrase, the air is human, to forgive divine. It's not an easy task to do that, especially for those who have lost someone, someone whom they care about, someone whom they love dearly. It's not an easy thing to forgive. But as we Christians are entering this Holy Week, where we will celebrate Good Friday, and we will remember Jesus Christ, who was on a cross. Jesus Christ, who was an innocent victim, who had done nothing wrong ever to hurt anybody else, found himself nailed to a tree. When he was up there, did he complain? Did he kibitz? Was he angry? No. He says, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Forgive them, for they do not know who it is we put on this tree. They do not know that I'm here to save them. They do not know that I am here to help them, to love them. Father, they do not know. It's out of that sense, the lack of knowledge, that I'm going to ask you to strive as best you can to forgive. To forgive. Because as we're going to ask God to forgive us someday, we have to show that mercy to others. That if we want our God to forgive us, we first must forgive others. And in so doing, we get the sense of healing. That God will touch our hearts and he will help them to heal. They will bring them together. He will bring us together. My prayer for all of you is that each and every one of you can find that ability within yourselves to forgive one another and all here, so that our Lord can touch your hearts and help you.
We're now going to take a 77-second moment of silence.